Hi zusammen und herzlich willkommen zu einem neuen Video von mir. Ich freue mich, dass du wieder eingeschaltet hast und ich habe heute noch einen richtig coolen Gast bei mir und zwar Danny und der kommt aus Dubai. Er ist dort relativ bekannt für seine Dubai Cityscape Bilder, also checkt auf jeden Fall mal seine Seite aus, wenn ihr ihn noch nicht kennt, aber ich denke mal, die meisten von euch werden ihn kennen. Danny, nice to have you here.
Yeah, my pleasure too.
Yeah, we have to speak in English now because Danny speaks English. So, Danny, how are you?
Good, I'm great. I'm very happy and I love Berlin.
It's nice to hear. How do you feel here in Berlin?
Yeah, first of all, I enjoy the cold. Yeah, because you know Dubai is like 42, 35 degrees. So far, it's my favorite weather. And I love Berlin because we have good friends here. Like you, taking care of us like the last 3 days and showing lots of support. You and Jean-Claude Castor as well, and Bassem.
Yeah,
Bassem Youssef. And also because Berlin, because this cosmopolitan city and the architectural, and I simply love the city.
Sounds nice. So you have a lot of difference in the temperature here, about 30 degrees.
Yeah.
Then you travel to Iceland tomorrow. It's also very cold. It's okay for you or just stressful?
No, I'm fine. I'm stressful a little bit because I want to make sure that we'll be very lucky with the weather because Iceland is very challenging in terms of weather and we are running two workshops, me and Daniel and another partner which is Shadi and he's from Spain. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's a very challenging weather in Iceland where we are expecting cold nights and long, short days and long nights. So we're going to spend lots of time at night, you know, following the northern light, trying to compose at night. So it's really challenging. I'm excited, but I'm always, you know, worried about many things, safety, people, because we have so many participants from different countries. And I want to make sure that everything is going well.
You sound like a really experienced photographer. How did you start photography and when?
Let me give you a small brief about myself. Before starting photography, I studied interior design and painting. I have a degree in painting and interior design. Then I started my business, started working in the entertainment business, retail and entertainment business for almost like 13 years. And I've been relocating between different countries. And the passion started maybe 7-8 years ago when I bought my first camera and I used to live
Which camera was it?
D80. Yeah.
Nice.
So I started with the D80 and I just decided to buy a camera because I was living in Egypt and I just had like so many vacations and I was alone. Because I left my country, so I started to take some pictures and by the time I found that I have passion for photography and I continued shooting and developing my skills and learning from others. Then I decided to quit my job and start focusing on photography. That was maybe 4 or 5 years ago when I moved to Dubai actually and it happened like that.
Do you love Dubai in that time again? Or is it now you have see everything and you want to move to another country maybe?
Well, if it's my own choice, I will definitely relocate to another country because I love learning new things, a new culture. But apparently at this moment, I'm very happy in Dubai because I want some stability because I've been relocating to different countries last 10 years. Between Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Lebanon, Jordan, Kuwait, Dubai. So it's time actually to just have some stability because I have my wife and my family. And I'm enjoying Dubai because Dubai, it's a hub. So where you can travel all over the world from Dubai. And for me, I can do my own business from any place in the world.
Dubai is also a good opportunity to have a lot of different vantage points, especially rooftops and so on.
Yeah.
Is there any special rooftop you like most?
Well, I've been new to rooftoping photography maybe since 3 years. And actually, for me, I love going to rooftops, and I love always shooting, you know, because I love shooting architecture, and it's I'm specialized in architecture and interior photography beside the corporate that I do. When you live in Dubai and you're shooting on a daily basis, weekly basis, and you get access to most of the rooftops, it becomes something which is normal for any photographer, which is something that you used to do it on a daily basis. But sometimes I rely on the weather changes. So when you have fog, when you have different weather conditions, it becomes more challenging and more exotic for the photographer.
Have you ever been scared about the height when you are on a rooftop?
No, never, because this is an advice I always just talk and during my public speech, that when you do rooftop photography, you have to be very careful. You have to go by security process and measurements, and you don't sneak to rooftops. You are an artist. You want to take your time. You get your approval. You do it in a safety way. So I never had this fear, but recently flying too much, and I'm getting scared a little bit about.
Oh really?
I don't know what's happening. Maybe when you reach the middle age, so you have some middle age cries. But you don't know. But so far I'm okay with heights.
Cool. Let's talk about your business. I mean, you can see Danny wears a Zeiss T-shirt. So yeah. What are your connection with Zeiss? Can you explain it?
Yeah, actually, a year ago, I had this opportunity to be appointed as an ambassador for Carl Zeiss, and I'm a global ambassador. Besides, I'm also a Nikon school member in the Middle East. For Zeiss, I was very lucky because it's a huge company and with excellent reputations in terms of lenses and optics. And I had this chance 1 year ago when they get like introduced by chance for someone who worked at Zeiss. Then they saw my images, and I want to add one thing here, because it's for me, it's not only photography, it's a business. When I got contact by Zeiss, the people of Zeiss, they saw that I'm very serious in terms of business. I have commitment. Because I do that because I'm more focusing on the business side. Even during our workshops, I don't focus a lot on the educational part. My role is more into the logistics and, you know, planning meetings and organize the workshops. This is what I love to do, because I came from a background, business background. So I know how to do business, and I'm serious all the time, you know. So commitment is very important as a photographer, even if you're working as a commercial photographer or as a hobby. So you have to be committed to what you love and what to do. It's a job at the end.
So how does it work when you especially want to gain new customers or something? Is it work in another way than especially in Germany, for example? And maybe in Germany it's more like, more harder to gain customers, or how do you do it?
Actually, I have my own license in Dubai, and I work with many agencies. It's all about PR, public relations, word of mouth. It's a very small market in the Middle East.
So it's more word of mouth or more social media, or what is most?
Yeah, that's the question here. Everyone thinks that if you're going big on social media, that's meaning you can get easily job on a corporate level, which is completely wrong. It's not necessarily to be famous on social media with millions of followers. That's mean you're going to get paid for a corporate job. You need to work on a professional level. You need to approach agencies. You need to build portfolio. You have to think sometimes when you work as a commercial photographer, not to do what you love, but at the end to go by the brief, by the client, by the concept you are shooting. So it's all about PR, and definitely social media. It's pushing you as an artist. You have lots of platforms, from Instagram, Facebook, 500px, Flickr. So many on Twitter. So even sometimes I'm getting jobs through social media. But my main focus is more on a corporate level and agencies and PR and direct contact.
So when we talk about social media, you are very successful on social media, especially on Facebook and Instagram.
No, not like Daniel
Chong. Not like Daniel Chong, but you are very successful. So around 50,000 followers you have now on Facebook, I think. around or 45
on Facebook. I'm not active on my page recently because, you know, Facebook with the organic reach, and you need, you know, to spend money. They are pushing us to spend money to get reach more and more. But
okay, so you're using more Instagram now?
Yeah, I have more Instagram. I have more than 40,000 followers, 45,000. Yeah. I'm focusing more on 500px. I have more than 75,000 followers. Yeah, but trust me, I don't look for the followers that much because I see that it's easy to gain followers, and especially when you get retweet and people, they use your images and they tag you. For me, it's more focusing on corporate level. And I noticed recently that it's a good idea to have your own blog and your own newsletter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you get to reach more people, and more people that have, they'll be interested to read stories, because on Facebook, it's not made as a blog or even Instagram. So I always recommend to go by your own blog.
And it's a safer way. For example, when Facebook shut down, Facebook can shut down every moment, so you don't have control about your content.
Yeah,
and when you use email marketing, it's your own page.
Exactly.
You can control it.
Yeah.
And you know what you do. What you do.
So. Yeah. And the good thing that when you have your own blog and people that are subscribing to your newsletter, and you will get the people that you want, you know, as a target, which is the people that are really focusing on photography. So sometimes I don't like to run ad on Facebook, you know, to reach thousands of people. At the end, you know, maybe 2% out of those 100 people that you reach that are interested in photography.
Yeah, but let me come back to the social media side. You have a lot of followers, and many people are asking, how do you gain such amount of followers? So do you have any plans? Do you post any every day one image, or is there any plan you have?
Do you mean on Instagram, right?
Yeah, on Instagram, for
example. On Instagram, I don't post, you know, thousands of images on a daily basis, you know, like 5 or 10. I don't like to spam my list, you know. Actually, I go by one image and I use the correct tags. Sometimes I tag some pages and they feature me back. So this is, it's very easy and it's very, but you know, all the time on Instagram, you got like ads, and people that want to sell you, you know, pay money to get featured. I don't do that. I don't suggest for people to buy likes. And as Daniel mentioned, so keep it organic, keep it simple, and be patient. And by time, if you are a good photographer, people, they will follow you.
Cool. Tomorrow you will fly to Iceland.
Yep.
What are you going to do there?
I'm going to go to the Blue Lagoon just to relax, chill.
Oh, sounds nice. Yeah, so you go on holiday.
No. Yeah, tomorrow actually we arrive around 2 p.m. to Iceland. The participants will start to arrive at night. My job is to take care of all the participants, because on a logistic level, I'm more active. So I have to make sure that everyone arrive on time. I have to drive them back to the hotel to make sure that they are relaxed, satisfied, the booking for the night, the first night. And we're going to do some first night presentation. And first, definitely, we're going to introduce people to each other. And we're going to do for a presentation about photography. We're going about what we're going to teach the next 8 days in Iceland, what kind of challenges we're going to face, what are our plans in terms of itinerary, and many things.
So when you do a workshop, for example, in Iceland, do you scout the locations before?
Yes, of course. Last year I went to Iceland. This is my second visit actually to Iceland. Last year I went to most of the locations, not all of them. Iceland, it's beautiful and you still have many things to see. Definitely, I never do any workshop without having ideas about the location, about the challenges we are facing, about the safety, and many things. So of course, definitely.
If you would meet a beginner photographer and you only have one advice, what kind of advice would it be? I already asked this to Daniel, but maybe you have another advice.
My advice, just to be modest, not necessarily that you took a nice image one day, you are a great photographer. Be patient, educate yourself, don't give up. Photography is real. It's a big world, you know. You have so many things to learn in all level in terms of composition, style, post-production, techniques, equipments. So just be patient and don't think that if you have a very expensive equipment or the best camera, that means you are a photographer. You need to work on your skills, on your compositions. You have to find your weaknesses. You have to listen what people are saying about your works, to accept criticize sometimes.
Yeah.
This is the best way that you can learn from.
Cool. So what are your plans for the future?
The plans of the future. Actually, I have so many plans. I'm very active. I have so many projects that I'm working on. I have some projects with Zeiss. So we're running like a project called Zeiss Around the World. So
nice.
I'll be traveling around the world, not only for my own, but also to run workshops and to promote Zeiss as a brand in terms of lenses. And we give some intensive training sometimes. On a personal level, yes, I have so many plans. I still want to visit many places on this earth. When I look to the map of the world and I see the countries that I visited already, maybe it's like 7% from the world. So I'm sometimes shocked that, okay, I still want to go to New Zealand maybe 5 times, you know, to Iceland 10 times, to Norway, to Lofoten, whatever, to Italy. You know, there are so many beautiful things. And the thing that it's challenging, I don't do only landscape photography. I do something called travel and landscape. So I do cityscape, landscape, street photography. I love photographing people, you know. You have so many topics in the world, there's so many countries and so many remote areas where I'm planning to visit, actually. That's beside my personal life.
Cool. So let's let's finish this video with some quickfire questions. What is your favorite camera brand?
Of course, I'm a Nikon since a long time ago. And I started with D80, then I switched to D300, then I went directly to full frame with D800 and D810. So far, D810, it's my favorite camera. I cannot tell you that Sony is much better, Canon is much better, you know. It's all about you as an artist. The gear is not important, but for me, I see that I don't need more than D810 because I'm enjoying my 36 megapixel. The game is not also on the camera, it's the lenses, the equipment we are using, etc. So all the brands are fine, all the brands are good.
Yeah.
The best lenses are Zeiss lenses, of course.
Yeah, that was my next question. Your favorite lens. So not just Zeiss as a company, but maybe you have a favorite lens from Zeiss.
I really like the Otus line. I'm talking here about 85mm if you want to do some portrait, 55mm if you want to shoot some street photography and portrait as well, and 28mm for landscape and architectural. And beside that, I like the Melvis line. The Melvis is replacing the classic Zeiss lenses. So we're starting from 15mm to 18mm to 21mm, up to 35, 50, 85, and the 135. And I'm really enjoying the 135, new Melvis.
By the way, we are shooting now the video with the 135.
Yeah.
So the camera pointing to Danny is shooting with
Zeiss. It's an amazing lens. I'm shooting landscape with 135, I'm shooting portrait, I'm shooting food photography for my corporate work, so it's an amazing lens. And I love also, I would love to spot also on Nikon, because I started with Nikon, you know, and I love the 1424 from Nikon. It's also one of the most beautiful lenses. And recently, I can't wait to get the new tilt shift 19mm. Yeah, maybe I can stop borrowing the 24mm from Daniel when I buy my new lenses. So,
yeah. Nice. Okay. Landscape or cityscape? What is better for you? Just your personal mind.
Honestly speaking, I found landscape it's more challenging because you have to scout for days. You have to many challenges: lighting, composition, logistics. Definitely cityscape. It's nice, but it's for me definitely landscape. Yeah,
okay, cool.
Yeah.
Your favorite country?
My own country, Lebanon.
Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
But for photography or just for?
Your favorite country.
Yeah, so far from the countries that I visit, I'll give an example, definitely Dubai for cityscape and skylines and architecture, of course. I love Egypt for landscape. It has lots of diversity from mountains to desert. They have one of the most beautiful desert in the world called the White Desert, and they have a Black Desert as well. That's beside the street photography and the different culture. For landscape, so far, Iceland is, I'm falling in love in Iceland. I would love to visit one day New Zealand and Patagonia, which is next year. I'm going to do a trip to Patagonia. So let's see after that. Ask me this question next year.
Okay, I will. When you go on holidays, are you going with your camera or without your camera?
First, I need
vacation. Vacation. So we definition. I will definite it more precise.
Yeah.
When you go on vacation with your wife, are you going with the camera or without your camera?
Yeah, it depends on her mood. Sometimes she allow me to take the camera, but when she see the tripod, she got scared because she know that I'm gonna wake up sunset and sunrise.
Yeah.
So I prefer to have my Zeiss Autos and on the 810 and doing some street photography, because when I travel my wife, we don't go for landscape countries. We mainly go for countries like those destination, like Rome, Paris. So street photography is the it's the best option without taking time from our vacation.
Blue hour in the morning or in the evening?
Golden hour.
Golden hour.
Yeah, I'm more into golden hour recently, actually. Maybe I'm more emotional recently, so I love this golden mood. But depend on the scene, depend if it's landscape, depend on the sky, if you have clouds, it's the light is diffused, depend of the subject. But for cities, honestly speaking, for cities, I still prefer the blue hour if you're shooting cityscape. But for landscape, I guess, the golden.
But in the morning or in the evening?
Golden hour in the morning, because light is softer. So I really enjoy shooting against the sun and get this beautiful, lights and
As we did yesterday.
Yeah, exactly.
So you can check out his profile on Facebook. There is a photo he took against the sun, a portrait of all of us. So it's really nice.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you for everything, Danny.
Thank you again. And I really appreciate your effort you did last 3 days with us. It's really amazing. And I really enjoyed your company. You are on a personal level completely amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
I don't want to mention the photography because you are a great artist. But on a personal level, this is what we really, really care as a photography.
Yeah.
That to build friends and to build a real community. It's not only about photography. It's about how we live and how we respect each other.
Thank you so much for your kind words. And
thank
if you.
You
want to check out more of Danny's work, you can go and explore his work on Facebook, on Instagram, 500 pics, and what else?
Yes.
This is three ones. Okay, I will put the links in the description and you can check it out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope we see you soon. Bye.
Bye.